Some of the bodies recovered from the landslide in Mako, Davao de Oro have been laid to rest. Meanwhile, displaced residents have been transferred to a tent city. Our very own Hernel Tokmo now joins us with the latest from there. Hernel, what more can you tell us?
Carmina, the death toll of the massive landslide in Masara village in the town of Mako, Davao de Oro has reached to 85, while 38 are still missing based on the latest situational report of the provincial government as of 7 p.m. Wednesday. Nine bodies were already laid to rest at the Mawab Public Cemetery on Wednesday afternoon, while several unidentified bodies were also buried in a mass grave as recommended by the Municipal Health Office for health and sanitation purposes. Meanwhile, search and retrieval operations remain dangerous due to ground movement and landslide. Apex Mining Incident Commander Ferdinand Dobley said rescuers even paused operations on Tuesday afternoon due to a ground movement. Meanwhile, the evacuees displaced by the landslide are set to be transferred to a tent city as schools can only accommodate up to 15 days, so it will not disrupt the learning of the students. Over 1,300 families are still staying in 10 evacuation centers in neighboring town of Mawab. The local government is currently searching for suitable relocation sites for displaced Masara residents. A particular lot owned by the church in Elizalde village is just one of the areas being considered to host a tent city for evacuees. Davao de Oro Governor Dorothy Gonzaga gave her assurance that the tent city will be safe, and they will have also received tents as donations from non-government organizations. After the 2008 Masara landslide, some residents were already provided with a housing program in Kinuban village. Gonzaga said they will just be advised to return there. Now that the LGU will strictly enforce the no-build zone in Barangay Masara, residents vowed to comply. The local government, together with the Mines and Geosciences Bureau, have also been searching for safe areas for permanent relocation. Those evacuees from other barangays could be sent back home as the LGU prioritized the Masara residents for now. And once the search and retrieval operations is over, authorities will keep an eye for those who might plan to build a structure there again. A memorial marker will also be placed to remember the people's lives lost in a tragic landslide. Meanwhile, Office of Civil Defense 11 Director Ednar Dayanghirang confirmed that the landslide victims have already received assistance. Aside from the burial and medical expenses, each family, as well as the injured victims, also received 10,000 pesos cash. Reporting from Davao, Hernel Tokmo, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Justice Department recommends criminal charges against those involved in last year's massive oil spill in Oriental Mindoro. Prosecutors found the shipping firm that operated the MV Princess Empress submitted faked documents, allowing the tanker to sail despite a non-compliance with regulations. Facing charges are the owners of the sunken vessel, some personnel of the Philippine Coast Guard, and the Maritime Industry Authority. The MV Princess Empress was carrying 800,000 liters of industrial fuel when it sank off the coast of Nauhan Town in February last year. The oil spill caused an environmental disaster for the province, costing billions of pesos in damages and loss of livelihood for residents. The social media account of the Philippine Coast Guard on X hacked. The PCG says the page was compromised. Its contents had been wiped out this morning, but have since been restored. The Coast Guard said it had regained control of the account with the help of X's support team before noon today. The latest incident follows last week's attempted cyber attacks on the websites of the PCG and other government agencies. The ICT department said the hackers might be from China, but had no proof if their actions were state-sponsored. With a truce in the word war between the two chambers of the Philippine Congress, Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri and House Speaker Martin Romualdez agreeing to work professionally following a very public clash over charter change. Zubiri and Romualdez met in Malacañang Wednesday during the birthday celebration of Chief Presidential Legal Counsel Juan Ponce Enrile. Zubiri says they plan to speak again next week to iron out other issues.
There was an agreement there, and the agreement did not follow through, not on our side, but because of that, nakainitan, nakaproblema. But again, for me, that's already water under the bridge. We discussed how we should put this behind us, all these this last 2 months of animosity, and start working professionally for the country. And I totally agree. I mean, we can disagree on many points, but for the people, we were elected by our chambers as the leaders of these chambers. We owe it to the people to work together.
Zubiri adds most of his colleagues in the Senate want to move forward from the spat. He now calls on House lawmakers to do the same.
I don't know why they still have their daily, press cons. Maybe they want to run for Senate. Some of these guys, maybe they're good. I'm happy. They should think about also planning to run for the Senate. When you have a press con, because you may say things out of script, out of the context of what you want to share, and it may hurt feelings. Right? So like yesterday, a couple of congressmen had said something again, right after me and the speaker already shook hands.
The Senate and the House have been in a verbal tussle over the controversial People's Initiative to amend the Constitution. The upper chamber strongly opposes the proposed joint voting of Congress, as senators believe this would diminish their power. Well, despite the Valentine's Day handshake between the congressional leaders, political analysts believe the tensions have yet to wane. Ronald Llama says there's still friction in the two houses of Congress, especially after it was revealed a government aid program may have been used to bankroll the People's Initiative for Charter Change.
Hindi na ayos ng Valentine itong away ng Senado at saka Kongreso. Parang yung unity, hindi rin naayos ng Valentine's Day. Mm. Mukhang tuloy-tuloy itong paghihiwalay, itong biyakan. No? Yung pinakahuli, itong away sa DSWD.
Yeah.
Yung 27 billion, nag-scale down itong away na ito.
For Dennis Coronacion, a stronger intervention from President Marcos is still needed to ease the tensions.
Sa tingin ko, since 2 weeks na may nakakaraan, sa tingin ko dapat naman i-level up niya na yung kanyang pag-intervene dyan, yung kanyang intervention. Sa tingin ko dapat magpakita na siya ng mas malakas na aksyon o mas mapakita niya na decisive siya, and siya dapat na masusunod. Kasi nga, tama kayo, no? Hindi na sumusunod sa kanya yung mga miyembro at saka liderato ng dalawang houses, ng dalawang chambers. So I think it's about time na pakita niya na kung sino talaga ang leader ng aliado na binuo nila. So I think it's about time for him to show a stronger stand and stronger voice pagdating sa issue na to.